the show here now that we're 5 minutes in.
All right.
Joe Rogan is headed to Spotify. The Joe Rogan Experience is the most downloaded podcast in the world. I don't even know that it's close.
Nope.
He has, on average, over 190 million downloads every month. Now, to go on and give you an idea, we have built up from the ground up, from nothing into something.
And we weren't famous when we started.
Right.
He was already an incredibly famous person when he first started his podcast. So day one, he had tens of thousands of listeners.
I'll give you an insight into us. We average, just our podcast, not the videos, anything like that, just the podcast, we average like 7,000 downloads a month.
Tens of people listen to this.
Yes, it's not crazy. We get, you know, hundreds per episode, but it's not like it's, but it's still pretty good when you're thinking about the fact that you've got people across the country.
We do this, we have a good time. Yeah. That's great.
He gets 190 million. Now, we do it daily.
Yeah.
He does it, what, 3 days a week?
No, he's 5 days a week. He's daily.
He's daily now. He was always daily.
If you go back and look, it was always five a week.
I thought he was like Monday, Wednesday, Friday for a long time.
No, I mean, he might have gone into a point where he did that, but for the most part, he tries to pump out five a week.
Yeah, especially now during the pandemic and everything. So.
But even before then, it was always, they're always pre-recorded.
Either way.
He didn't pump anything out live.
No. Well, I mean, he does on YouTube, but not for podcast.
They haven't done live on YouTube in over a year.
Have they not?
No.
Damn.
He kept getting in a bunch of trouble showing things, and they want to make sure they can edit stuff out
because
they were getting lawsuits because something was copyrighted that they showed in the background.
Oh, and then they couldn't monetize it and whatever. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
All right. Michael said, I do need to get some WCE swag. Matt said, I need WCE things for my office. Yeah, we need to hook that up.
We talked about that. We kicked around some ideas for different stuff.
I've still got a couple of those shirts that you gave me, Chris. Yeah. If you guys will DM me and give me an address, I'll send them out. I'll send you some shirts. So we'll get you taken care of one way or another.
If you're not like a normal extra large size, let us know. We'll get you a shirt.
Yeah, we'll get you taken care of. McKinnon said, all depends on his comedy gigs or his hunting trips as to whether or not he's daily. But here's the thing. 190 million downloads every month. The numbers that we read last year, he made what, $90 million.
So let's talk about the dollars. Cause I don't care about downloads because I don't understand that world. That's Gary's world. I go to the bank. Okay.
Yeah.
Last year there was a report from some website group that but they were only tracking podcasts. This is just podcast money and revenue. He was number one with $90 million straight from his podcast. It's not his YouTube channel or any other streams revenue. That's just $90 million from the podcast. The number two was like two of the chicks that do the your favorite murderer kind of guy thing, whatever. And I think they were like $30 million, which is a metric shit ton of money to two jokers that are talking to tens of people. All right. But B, there is a chasm there. And then like between them and the fifth place person was like, they were 30 and the fifth place person was like 18 million. And then everyone in between was, you know, 5 to 6 million apart. Like they're all pretty close. And then there's literally a grand canyon of money between Joe and them. Yes. You would have to take three of the number two podcasts, combine them together to equal what he brings in. Putting them behind Spotify only and taking them off of Apple and Google and all the other podcasting networks, my first question and fear was, because Spotify does have a paywall, right? Like there are exclusive things that you can pay for through Spotify. I was afraid, and I don't, we're not 100% certain here.
No, we're certain. I've saw the details
it's
on
not,
that part.
It's not going to be behind their paywall.
It is not
right?
behind the paywall.
Then I'm good because I'll still use Spotify, but I won't. I can't pay for any more subscription shit. I just can't do it.
Well, I mean, nobody on earth can pay for every subscription. That's the problem that comes with cutting the cord, right? Like you can't pay for every single channel. Like you're going to have to pick and choose what you pay for because everybody wants $10. Well, $10 doesn't sound like much per month. But when you start adding it up and you've got
19 subscriptions, now I'm at a $200 thing a month.
Like, why not just get cable at that point, you know, which is the same thing. Matt said he had to get his workouts in, then go hunt, smoke some hash, then butcher deer in front of vegans. And then he asked, what was Stern at back in the day? Stern never did podcast.
No, Stern's never done a podcast. The I don't remember the deal. Do you remember how much it was?
$500 million over 10 years.
Yeah, so $50 million a year, and that was, what, 30 years ago? 20 years ago he went to Sirius?
No. It wasn't 20. It was
I think it was 20. I was in college, man.
No, it wasn't 20 years ago, though. Maybe 15, maybe.
Okay, well, college is more 15 years. That's probably right.
Yeah, okay, maybe 15. Ben said, how is Pat McAfee not first?
He ain't close. He's not even top 100.
No, not even anywhere. Now, he does make a really good living. He doesn't focus on his podcast anymore, though. He's got a radio show. So it's completely different. Michael said, that's how they get you 10 here, 10 there. Yeah, 100%. I mean, everybody wants to get theirs. McKinnon said, Joe is also extremely diversified in comedy, podcasts, supplements, gym ownership, et cetera. Yeah, but we're not talking about any of the other stuff.
We're talking about podcasts. I'm talking about just his podcast money alone, because that was public record from Forbes.
Yes.
$90 million from one revenue stream.
Oh, yeah. Matt said, Joe is just an average guy, very open to people and ideas. When he interviews people, he has a questioning mind. It's incredible. Yeah.
He is the best long-form interviewer in the world. In the world,
yes.
Okay? 2020 and all those old news plays, Walter Cronkite, none of those guys have anything on Joe when it comes to questioning, asking. And he's not afraid to call, even his friends, he's not afraid to call them out on their bullshit. When they say ridiculous things on his show, he'll stop them and say, whoa, hang on.
Yeah.
Is that real? Like, did you just make that? Like, you can't just come on here and say shit.
Oh, and he does it with people that
so much.
He does it with people he doesn't know as well.
Like, yeah, that's anybody. Yeah. He just treats everybody the same. And my biggest thing, we all love Joe, and he's one of the most popular guys in the world, but 80% of why he's so likable, he really seems to be the most reasonable person alive. And that's literally my only goal in life, is to just be reasonable.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't care about being agreeable all the time, but I need to have rational thought and I need to have logic behind it. And if it's nonsense, then I'm okay with nonsense, but I need to make sure it's clear what I'm saying is nonsense in my opinion.
Yeah.
But for the most part, and that's why he's trusted. That's why people love him, is because I trust everything coming out of his mouth. He truly, honestly believes. And if it's nonsense and he doesn't believe it and it's just goofy and him being silly or fun, he lets you know that.
Yeah. No, I agree with that part. Now, what I'm curious about, because not only are they taking it where it's a podcast exclusive on Spotify only, they are also moving his full episodes off of YouTube. Mm-hmm. Now, they're still going to allow some clips, but to get the full show, including video, because Spotify is moving into video podcasts.
Audio's getting into video, yep.
The amount of money that they would have to be paying him.
We have no idea what this deal is worth right now.
Right, so right now we're guessing, which is, you know, again, a hypothetical. But it's kind of fun at this point, because he has to be made, that Spotify had to give him such an outrageous deal. Because right now, if anybody searches on Google or wherever else, they pull him up on YouTube. He's able to monetize YouTube. He's able to monetize basically everything. He's not exclusive to anyone, but he has never been on Spotify. His podcast is not on Spotify right now. We are. He's not. But he did that on purpose, I think. I don't know that, but either way, it seems like he would have done it on purpose, because it's so easy. Like, I mean, we hooked it up and it was, you know, like that, just nothing. So I think that this was a
concerted effort. I just wonder why you would have left him off, because he couldn't have foreseen that. Well, I won't let them be on. I won't be on their platform at all. And then one day they'll come calling and offer me a sweetheart deal.
I don't think he saw that. I think he was already comfortable with what he had and he didn't want to add anything else. Like there's no reason to split it up where he's got to go search for anything else. He's already making enough. He's already doing whatever. If you think about $90 million just off the podcast, then the YouTube stuff, I mean, every single day he is getting tens of millions of hits on YouTube. That is worth millions of dollars a year. More than likely, he's making $50 million a year off of YouTube.
Yep.
For them to take him exclusively to Spotify, they've got to be paying him at least $200 million a year.
I thought 150. I thought 150 is what I would guess.
I mean, 150 is probably close to what he's making anyway.
Yes, but right now he's actually having to do all those other things. And now he just shows up, talks into a mic, and sends it to Spotify.
I mean, that is a good point.
That extra work is not work. It's just something he doesn't have to deal with.
Well, I think the other side is, Matt said, have you seen his kettlebells? Yeah, they're ridiculous. Yeah. No, I think the other side of this is you're also taking away his ability to be in front of an even bigger audience, right? So you got to pay him for that as well. Like, you got to pay for the exclusivity.
Well, I don't know. I bet his numbers don't go down at all. I bet Spotify's numbers jump through the roof.
Oh, I bet their numbers do as well.
People who are Joe Rogan fans aren't going to just say, oh, well, I guess I won't listen anymore. No, it's free. I'm going to download this app, and I'm going to still listen. I'm just going to get in the habit of using this new app that outside of the other app. I had to do that with a couple of the shows that I've listened to that, you know,
that's you just got to start listening on other things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so now it's easy for me to just move to that platform when I want to look for stuff.
Yeah.
That's okay.
No, I think there will be a dip at first. And eventually over time, most everybody will switch over.
I bet that dip lasts less than a week.
You might be right. But so it starts in September that he will be on Spotify, but it's not exclusive in September. It's exclusive starting January 1, 2021. So, big time news. I mean, that's pretty massive. That's the biggest name in this realm. And I mean, he found out how to make it work for him. So cheers to Joe Rogan. Let's go on and jump topics. Let's move.